So, welcome to this live stream. Hi, I'm drinking my... Hello, Penny. I'm drinking my coffee. My after-lunch coffee, a bit late today. And I'm having this day when I'm really, really tired and feel a bit sad, as we all do sometimes. So I thought I was going to have picked out some books that helps me to color these days too. Hello, Elin. So this is going to be like, I don't know what your tips are when you're feeling a bit down or tired and still want to color and not do any ambitious. And because it's Saturday, I can eat some chocolate to my coffee. I don't know, do you have that in other countries too? In Sweden we have this Saturday candy, when most children get candy on Saturdays, so they won't eat all the time. Hello Andrea, sorry. I'm eating chocolate and drinking coffee. Hello. Hello, Flora. I'm streaming. I didn't think I should stream today because I didn't think I should color today because I'm a bit tired and yeah, don't have so much energy. But then I thought I could show you. Oh, Swedish chocolate, but I think this is Belgian chocolate. Yeah! So, things to do when you want to color, but not to do anything ambitious. Kirkles. That is one thing you can do. I can do. This is Kirkles Masterpieces. And right now it looks just crazy. I can show you some. I finished this one. This one. Is this finished? Yes. That one. So maybe you, this is like a coloring by number. Yeah, Mona Lisa too. It's like coloring by number, but you have to choose 5 different colors, from lightest to dark. I think this is the way I'm going to use them. So this, the darkest is number 1, this is number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5. And I think I will start with the darkest one. So these are kind of small, but you just color. Oh, this was 1 too, so I didn't have to be so cautious. So you color all the number 1 spaces with this one, and then you go to number 2. I'm using Pitt Artist Pen. I think they are good for this. They have to be... It has this brush tip. It has to be something small, and I think it's... I would not have the patience to use pencils on this. But I think maybe you have done that, Marie. I know you have done a lot of Kirkles. So yeah, this is gonna take a long time, but it's kind of cozy when you have decided the pencils, the colors. It's just filling in. Something similar is this is fun to color by numbers. So this is actually color by number for kids, but I have this. Yeah, Kirkles can be really relaxing. So I mean, this is children's book, but I know there, I guess there is adult coloring books for two with color by number. So, I mean, here it's just following. It says one red, orange, green, gray, yellow, blue, purple, and pink. I'm not gonna color it all in. I'm just gonna try it six purple. Yeah, dot to dot. Yeah, but oh, alcohol markers, maybe that's good too in Kirkles. I don't have so many alcohol markers. I have to see what you were writing. Yeah, Flora got the question if she has slept well. First full night sleep since meeting you great crazy ladies. Oh, hello, Susan Kitty. I'm just, it's no fancy coloring today. It's just showing what I can sometimes do when I have this lack of energy but still want to color something. So let's see. Six purple. I just start with the six. Okay. I think I should have used markers for this too. Not alcohol markers because they will bleed through. But water-based markers, just because it's quick, and I mean, the result is not important here. It's just the feeling, to feel the pencil against the paper and see the color come to life, and don't not have to decide it for yourself. Oh, you're going to see Mamma Mia, the movie. Great. Yeah, I know. I was a bit late today with my stream. My coffee was late too. I had to do some things. So, this was actually color by number. And a day like this, when you feel a bit down, I think actually children coloring books can be quite relaxing. I have some this old owl's coloring book which I colored a bit in, and once again this is not about the result, it's just coloring. And I have this one, it's also a children's coloring book, Bamse. Oh, so Marie, you can just choose whenever Flora is going to stream. What luxury. I don't know. It was a long time since I colored in any books like this. And I'm actually going to use my Crayola Twistables because I just want something quick and relaxing. Yeah, have a nice time on the cinema, in the cinema with Mamma Mia, Marie. These were my favorite once upon a time. These Crayola Twistables. Now I don't like them as much, but I thought they are quick and easy. You are her streaming slave. Oh boy. Yeah. So I just color in. I don't think these are great for shadowing or blending. But when you're just going to fill in quite big areas, which they are in children's book, they are nice. Hello, Katrina, Flutterby. I'm just showing, I'm not doing any fancy coloring today. Maybe later, but I was a bit tired. So I'm showing what I sometimes do when I have these days. Just so I can color anyway and feel the relaxation with coloring. So I have these children's books, dots by dots. No, I don't have that, but it's coloring by number, and Kirkles, which is kind of coloring by number. And another children's thing I have. This is actually kind of strange thing, but I thought I should show you anyway. It's not, you are not using pencils in this or crayons. You are using water in the pencil. Yeah, does anyone in other country knows about Bamse, the Swedish cartoon Bamse? Oh, you have to go, Andrea. See you later. No, it's very, very famous in Sweden. This is just adding water, and then the colors will come. They have already colored it. So I know someone accidentally bought this and was really disappointed because it wasn't coloring. It's more adding water. So of course it's meant for children, but sad, bad day, it can be kind of relaxing to just go over it with a pencil. No, pencil is, sorry, now I used the Swedish word for brush. With a brush. And see the colors come to life, and you don't have to choose any colors at all. Yeah, it's just adding water. I mean, it's very childish, but very calming. I wouldn't do this for a long time, but I actually done, I think, one or two pictures in it. Oh, they choose green for their tree. Yeah, I think you understand the principle about this. Yeah, it can take a long time to choose colors. And the last thing I do when I want to color but not having a good day, when I just want to be relaxing and super cozy, is this Color Me Calm. I don't have the other books in the series, but just any book with mandalas in, because I can think that mandalas and patterns, repeated patterns, can be really calming. Oh, here we have one. And I'm not that good, as I see in someone like you, Anna, but you're not here, maybe? I've seen so many wonderful mandalas, but for a bad day, I don't think the most important is the result. You shouldn't feel any pressure. So I just choose two colors. Light magenta and manganese violet. She's at the beach. Okay, so Anna at the beach. And I might add some more color in the end, but mostly when I color mandalas, I just color it in, one color at a time. Mostly I use markers, so I don't have the pressure to shade. Mostly when I do mandalas, I choose one color, or as this time, two colors, and I color first with one color every space that can be filled with that color. And the only rule for me is that the areas should not be connecting, because if I colored these little dots with purple now, they wouldn't be visible. So they have to be separated by different colors, or white. You can leave spaces white too. So I feel that mandalas are very relaxing, but mostly when I color them, when I feel the urge to color a mandala, it is when I'm not super happy. So that's also a sign to myself that okay, you are coloring a mandala. How are you feeling inside today? But it's something about the repeatedly patterns that is calming. Yeah, Marie, see you later. Have a nice time at the movie. So I would just go over this with purple and then the more pink purple, light pink, light purple, and then see how it looks and what spaces are still uncolored and maybe you need another color. But I don't think mandalas should have more than like, for me, 3 to 5, 2 to 5 colors, so it wouldn't look messy. So I think I will just color these in. I will not color the whole mandala with you because I think that would be boring for you. So I thought that by doing some childish coloring today, drinking my coffee, eating some chocolate, and being with you for a moment would make me more happy. So maybe later today I can color another picture, more advanced picture. Maybe finish my picture in daydreams, the harder. Actually, these colors were kind of similar. It is not boring. Okay, thank you. I mean, when I watch other people stream, I never get bored, but when you are doing the stream yourself, it feels like who on the earth would want to watch this? Especially when you're doing things like this, just really simple coloring. But yes, it is less stressful because sometimes, I mean, coloring can be so relaxing and fun. And addictive. I can't stop coloring since I started 2 years ago. But sometimes a picture with like skin or a lot of details, it can feel stressful if you. Yeah, it can be hard to choose colors, or it can be like you feel you have to make it super beautiful. Yeah, you have started your coloring in daydreams for Katrina. Well, you can take all the time you need. We shouldn't feel any press. Actually, yesterday I finished this picture for Johanna Bestfors competition, and some of you might have seen that stream, where I was coloring that one. And it was super fun, and I said then that I loved deadlines, which is true, because then I actually finished something. But yesterday it was kind of stressful to finish it before the deadline, and then I thought, why do I always have to be so late? And it was not that cozy as this is. So I don't really have any plan with my mandala, and I'm not doing shades and stuff. I'm just pressing quite hard. Yes, of course you can take your time, and if you want to participate in the Color Along Daydreams for Katrine, which I'm co-hosting, it will run all of 2018. So you have a lot of time. Actually, the difficult thing is when you have started to do like shadings and things like that, it's hard not to do it. Just pressing super hard to get some, and super soft just to make some transition here. But I'm not going to blend this, or I'm not going to create a masterpiece. It's just being about being in the moment. Okay, so now I jumped over one, so now it's not. I have two here and two here. Well, never mind. Yeah, exactly, Lisa. It can be so wonderful to just do something mindless after an intense, detailed deadline page. Yeah, mindful. Actually, I think I'm doing this purple too. But I think the light purple was too similar. I should have chosen something more light pink. Yes, it's nice to shade, of course. I love to shade too, but when I did a lot of mandalas a long time ago, when I really didn't feel well, when I had a lot of anxiety, I always colored mandalas. And then, yeah, here it was. Here's a mandala where I, for my first time, tried to do something circular, like a globe, to feel 3D. And I used classic, Faber-Castell Classics. I remember how happy I was with those pieces, or was it whatever it is. And I have colored. Okay, so I have forgotten that I used pencils. Oh, hello, Paige. No, we didn't know your name. Where are you? Here in Sweden, it's like it's after 3 p.m. So it must be, if it's 9:30 in Eastern U.S., I guess it's 3:30 p.m. in Sweden. And here I did one, not so beautiful. This brown is really ugly. I think I used Stabilo, maybe Stettler felt tip pens. So these were like, yeah, maybe 1.5 year or 2 years ago. This was the first thing I did with markers, alcohol markers, so it was bleeding through. And this I only started, but never finished. And here they had already a picture of it. So then I thought it was difficult to not try to do the same colors as they did. Yeah, and here are one mandala. Hello, Katrina. Yeah, here I have one I have not done. Yes, I think that was. And what do I. Here are the patterns section. But I don't think I have colored them. No, it was the mandalas I liked most. No, here are the patterns. I mean, these are kind of mandalas, but they are not circle-shaped. They are squares. But those I colored. I remember I had this book in the bed next to me. So instead of reading or doing something else before going to bed, going to sleep, I colored mandalas. That helped me with my anxiety back then. And I mostly used, like you can see, felt tip pens, water-based markers. You think, textile designer? Yeah, maybe. Yeah, all of these looks like textile. This is really not so looking so good, but well, it's very relaxing. Maybe I will have purple here. So when people sometimes says that coloring is like mindfulness, I don't think that's true. Not all the time. But I do think when coloring mandalas, I can come to that stage when it feels like mindfulness. And when I say I don't think it's the other coloring I do is like mindfulness, it's not because I feel stressed about it, but that's because, well, there are more decisions to make, like what colors to do, and it's a bit more intense. It's a lot of fun, but when I do pictures with sceneries or animals and things, it feels less good if the outcome is terrible. When I do a mandala, well, I really don't care so much about the result. Yeah, that's true. Everything can be mindfulness if you are feeling mindful. So you mean it's just a way for the creator of the coloring book to make it feel, look better, to sell more books. Oh, thank you, Isabel Riveroje. I liked your too. I loved it. It was, wow, I really liked your version. I've seen so many wonderful versions of this ivy in the boat with the mouse coloring for Johanna Bessfer's competition. Yeah, I know. And that's so sad when we are so stressed about the outcome, so we can't feel the happiness about coloring. Spiritual materialism. Yes, but are we not like that, we human? I'm like that. I think that everything will be better if I just own that coloring book, or if I just own that set of pencil, or if I just buy that dress, or if I just start to exercise, or if I just, yeah, you know. Hola! So I probably bought some books because I read it was mindful. And actually, I think this is kind of mindful. But Lisa, weren't you going to stream? Oh, you're going to have breakfast watching my live stream. Beautiful, Isabel. Yeah, you're starting your weekend. I'm still on vacation, so it still seems like every day is like vacation. But soon I will start to work again when the school starts again. Yeah, but I actually think that buying coloring supplies is helping. The first year, or maybe the first half year, when I colored a lot and started to hang out on Facebook, because I started to be on Facebook before Instagram, and met other coloristas from Sweden, it really helped me a lot. But it also made me buy a lot of stuff, because they talked about things and showed things they had that I must have. And actually, that looking for beautiful things online and buying them and getting them in the post box, it was really joyful. And I've actually used everything, and it have given me a lot of happiness. Yes, I'm coloring a mandala. I just showed the other things, but I don't think it is so fun for someone to watch. I think a mandala might be more fun to see, and it was more, well, I thought it was most fun to color. These color by number can be great, but I was not in the mood for them today. I was in the mood for a mandala and some friendship talk with you. Because I know when I do pick up the pencils and start to color, I feel better after a while. So now I feel better. So I'm doing some light purple here. Okay, so Lisa, if you are here still, and if you want to go streaming, if you want to do that, I can stop streaming and join your stream, or I mean, watch your stream instead. Yes, we do have these days when we're not feeling so well, for some reasons, different reasons. It can be just that it has been a lot of stuff going on, and or that you, something has happened, or that you are tired or stressed. But I know coloring almost always helps me, but it has to be the right coloring. It can't be any fancy, difficult, ambitious project. Yeah, okay. Just tell me when to stop, Lisa, so we can go to your stream. We have, after this streaming for Katrina event, we all think it's so much fun to stream, so we can't stop. And I think that is super fun. Yeah, perfect, Flora. I hope I can watch some of the streams. I will have to go and do some dinner and some other stuff, but I hope I can see some of your streams. And maybe I have missed some of your questions or conversation. If I have, I'm sorry. You were streaming almost alone. I'm so sorry we missed that, Andrea. I just came home. Of course, Tony. Hello. Coffee, coffee, coffee. But it has been here for a long time, so it's not so hot anymore. Not as I don't like it super hot, but not super cold either. No, it's not raining. It's sunny and windy. Hello, Alex. Cheers, coffee. Yeah, goodbye. Thank you for joining. Was it Paige? I hope I pronounce it right. So, I have shown what I'm coloring when I'm not feeling very well, when I'm tired, as I am today, and feeling a bit down. And I started to show these curricles and painting by number and children's coloring book, and ended with this. And this was what I wanted to do today, coloring a mandala. Oh, you're at your parents. We have this, you know, we streaming addicts from last weekend are going to stream today. It seems like we have not planned it together, but I was just coming home and drank my coffee and streamed a bit later than usual. And after me, Lisa will stream. Andrea have streamed already. Maybe she stream again, I don't know, but her stream can be watched after. And maybe Anna will stream later today. And Flora has said she's going to stream. Oh, thank you, Pernilla. Hello. And if you want to see a really beautiful mandalas, I think Anna put some color to me, did an amazing mandala recently. And I think you, Pernilla, has made some really amazing mandalas too. Mostly when I do a mandala, I in the end put in some color that don't feel good. Actually, I don't throw away pictures which I'm not happy with, because mostly I color in my books and I don't want to take anything away from them. I just try to say them the best I can and see them as a process. That was how I colored back then. But I have colored some really ugly mandalas, which I have thrown away. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Alex. I just picked two colors for the start, and maybe I take one more in the end. But I mostly, when I do mandalas, I choose one or two colors, and then I color every space I can with them before I go to next color. So my only rule is that areas should not be next to each other, so not purple next to purple, so we can see. But sometimes I do that. I just realized that sometimes I maybe do the same colors next to each other, but mostly not. So I think I'm going to do this with a lighter purple. Yes, I think that's fun too, to go back and see that. I mean, if you compare yourself with other people on Instagram or Facebook or YouTube, there is always going to be people that are better than you on coloring. And you can't compare yourself with everyone. You need to see, you need to find out what the reason you color is and try to remember that when you color. And have noticed that my coloring had became better and better, but it happened so slowly. It can take like half a year before something is changing. Then I don't have made a big effort to become better. I just have colored and colored and colored with a lot of happiness, because it has helped me so much. But even if you don't look at YouTube channels, I have started to look at tutorials and things like that now, but in the start I didn't do that as much, but it was still fun. Ah, Lisa is going to take over and stream. So thank you everyone for watching this live stream. Yeah, I'm coloring super fast. Yeah, maybe I do that. But it's not finished. But I'm going to watch Lisa's stream now and be back at another moment. See you later. Thanks for the coffee time, Tony. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't take ages. I'm kind of fast colorista. Oh, Flora, I'm so happy you joined and was with me this stream.